Hello, Airbus Cockpit Coach here. Got a short video for you today, running through the alternate braking system. So some of you may have wondered what this gauge here is for. This shows the accumulator pressure, which is so accumulated hydraulic pressure, which is stored on the aircraft. And below, we got our left and right braking system. The park brake is fed solely from the accumulator pressure system, and the accumulator itself is topped up using the yellow system, the yellow hydraulic system, which is fed from engine 2, or the electric pump if it's on, or it can be fed if the green system's operating. Engine 1, the transfer unit will supply power to the yellow system, so it can be fed also from the green system. Now, one of the reasons why we put trucks under the wheels of the aircraft, particularly important when you're leaving overnight, because the pressure shown here at the top will decrease over time. And when leaving the aircraft, you know, for long periods, you will find that the brake pressure itself is becoming less and less, and you may not find your aircraft where you left it after a period of time. So that's one of the reasons why we chock the aircraft. So at the moment, that system is not being topped up. So if I made repeat applications of pressure by selecting the park brake to off and on, there we go, you'll see the pressure at the top in the accumulator is dropping. Eventually, we'll get to a point where you see the brakes, the pressure on the brakes is becoming less and less, and the accumulator pressure is heading towards zero. And essentially, at this point, here we go, we've got a warning now, the pressure's dropping. At this point, the aircraft really has no brakes whatsoever. We don't have any hydraulic systems running. There's nothing topping up our stored accumulator pressure, so we are empty of brake pressure on this aircraft. So before we push the aircraft back, we also want to make sure, before engine start, we want to make sure we've also got this level of pressure in the green to make sure we can put the park brake on before our engines are started, and the usual sources of hydraulic pressure from the engines becomes available. Now, to simulate engine start, I can, you know, having two operating systems, yellow and green, I can just turn on the electronic Y pump, which is a switch up here, which is right at the back. Pressing that, we will power on the electric pump, which will supply the yellow, and the power transfer unit also detects here that the pressure is lower than 500 psi, is a 500 psi difference, and will then transfer power across to green. So the power transfer unit will supply pressure either way, from green to yellow or yellow to green, if there's a difference of 500 psi or more on one side. So now, this is pretty much how I would have it if with engines operating. Obviously, the blue system would also come on with engine start. That operates when AC power is available to the aircraft, i.e. an engine running. But the blue system has no bearing on brakes. So at the moment, we've got the system recharged, because the yellow system is operational and charged itself, so this is top back up. And during engine start, what would happen is the braking will switch over primarily from the alternate system, to be primarily operating through the normal system, which is powered by the green hydraulic system. And before we as we begin our taxi off, We perform a check, we look at this system, and we confirm that pressure is zero. So I'm going to push the brakes now. Pressure is zero. I'm pushing the brakes fully down, and this hasn't moved. So that means we've moved from the alternate braking system through the normal system powered by the green hydraulics. Now, that wasn't the case. Again, you'd see these needles move up, and that would then confirm that we're still on the alternate braking system, which has a limited amount of pressure available, and that's not what we want, particularly before takeoff, when we may have to reject a takeoff and apply a lot of braking. So that's why that check's confirmed. It's not so much to check that the brakes are working and the aircraft stopping. It's to look at ensuring that the systems have transferred from alternate to normal. Now, we've had an issue with braking. We can also, you know, if you're coming into land and you're landing and our brakes are ineffective, one of the issues may be with the anti-skid system. And one of the procedures we would apply is turning that system off. As soon as you turn this off, you come straight onto the alternate system here. So if I apply brakes now, you'll see that we're on the alternate system. The maximum brake pressure we can use is 1,000 PSI. So when we press the brakes, we want to make sure that we're not exceeding that 1,000 PSI. We're not losing pressure because we still have the yellow system operating, so it's being continually topped up. Now, that's the fastest way of getting onto alternate brakes should you have an issue while using normal brakes. Also, in the event of complete loss of braking, so we lost all hydraulic systems. Simulate that now. Again, it's very similar to what we just showed before. If we're coming into land, we've lost brakes, we would want to be ensuring that we're on the alternate system, on the alternate brake system. But again, we use a pumping action, so we'd be repeatedly pumping the brakes, make sure they're no more than 1,000 PSI, and that's the action we'd use, and we'd continue that until obviously there's no pressure available. And you can see there the effectiveness of the brakes is decreasing. Master caution for that now. That's the process we would apply. So, to get on to alternate brakes, even with your green systems operating, turning the anti-skid and nasal steering off, we'll put you onto alternate if you're having difficulty braking the aircraft on that system. So that's a quick look at the alternate braking system and this pressure gauge here and what we use it for. Pretty important. It just gives you an idea of how that's topped up, what it feeds, and also its application in terms of day-to-day operations. If you've got any questions on that, please drop them in chat. I'll do my best to answer them. Other than that, I look forward to seeing you on a live stream soon, or look out for the next tutorial. Thanks for watching.